In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to install all the applications that we require for this course. The applications we're going to install are Git-SCM, Virtualbox, Vagrant, Atom Editor, and the ModHeader's Chrome extension. All five of these applications are available for Windows, Linux, or Mac, so you can follow along in the course regardless of which operating system you're using. I'm going to be demonstrating how to install these applications on a Windows machine, but it's super easy to install and you should be able to install it on your own operating system if you're using Linux or Mac. So let's start by installing Git-SCM. Load up the Chrome browser and head over to git-scm.com. On the homepage, click on the Download for Windows button, and this will take you to the Downloads page and automatically start the download. Let's wait for that to finish and then we'll continue on with the next steps. Once the download is finished, click the installer to start the installation. On the user account control screen, click on Yes to approve it. And then on the information screen, click on Next. You can leave the Select Destination Location screen as default and click Next. And you can also leave the Select Component screen as default and click on Next. Leave the Select Start Menu Folder default and click Next. On this screen, on Windows, you're going to want to check this last box here. So use Git and optional Unix tools from Windows command prompt. We check that so that Git installs some of the Unix tools that we're going to need later on in the course. If we're using a Mac or Linux, then you don't need to worry about this because it already comes with the installed Unix tools that we need. So make sure the use Git and optional Unix tools from the Windows command prompt is checked and click Next. Then leave the Choosing HTTPS Transport backend page default, click Next. You can leave the line ending settings as default and click on Next. On the Terminal Emulator page, click Next. And leave these two checked and enable symbolic links unchecked and then click on Install. Git will now be installed on the system. So let's wait for that installation to complete and then we'll continue. Once the installation completes, you can uncheck the View Release Notes and click Finish. Now we're going to test that it's been installed correctly by clicking Start and searching for Git Bash. Click on the Git Bash desktop app to load it up. If you're on Linux or Mac, you can just load up the terminal and type Git to check that it's been installed. We can see that the Git Bash has been installed, so it looks like Git has been successfully installed on our Windows machine. So let's close that off, and next let's install VirtualBox. Go back to the browser and head over to virtualbox.org. On the VirtualBox homepage, click on this huge download button here, and then download the one that's relevant for your machine. So we're using Windows, so I'm going to download the one for Windows hosts. And let's wait for that download to complete and then we'll continue. Okay, so once the download completes, click on the VirtualBox installer to start the installation. On the welcome screen, click on Next. On the custom setup screen, click Next. On the custom setup screen part 2, leave it all default and click Next. On the network interfaces warning, click on Yes. And then finally click Install to start the installation. When the user account control screen pops up, click Yes to approve, and we'll wait for VirtualBox to install, and then we'll continue. Okay, so once it's installed, you can leave the Start Oracle VM VirtualBox checked and click Finish. We'll just let VirtualBox start up so we can see that it's been installed successfully. Okay, so it looks like VirtualBox is there. Now let's move on to installing the next application, Vagrant. So close off the VirtualBox and go back to the browser and head over to vagrantup.com. On the Vagrant homepage, click on the download button and then choose the one that's relevant for your operating system. So again, we're using Windows, so I'm going to download the one for Windows. Now we'll wait for that download to complete and then we'll continue. Once the Vagrant installer is downloading, let's click on it to start the installation. On the welcome screen, click Next. On the license screen, the end user license agreement, you want to read this thoroughly and then click on I accept and click Next. In the location to install Vagrant 2, just leave it the default and click on Next. Finally, click Install to start the installation. When the user account control screen pops up, click Yes to approve, and then we'll wait for the download, or we'll wait for the installation to finish. Okay, so once Vagrant is installed, click on Finish, and it's gonna ask you to restart your system. I'm gonna click Yes to restart now. Once your machine is restarted, let's load up the Git bash or the terminal if you're on Linux or Mac and check that Vagrant has been installed. Vagrant website's popped up here, so I'm just gonna close that off. All right, so once you're in the Git bash, type Vagrant version and hit enter. This will tell you the version of Vagrant that's installed on the system. It can take a few seconds to run the first time you run it. You can see here that we have the latest version 1.9.3 installed. So Vagrant is successfully installed. Let's move on to the next application and install Atom on the system. Now, Atom is the easiest application to install. Just load up Chrome, and again, head over to the website, atom.io, and click on Download Windows 64-bit Installer, and we'll wait for that download to finish, and then we'll install Atom. Once the Atom installer is downloaded, click it to start the installation. Now, that's all you need to do to install Atom. Once you click it, it will automatically start the installation and it will install on the system without us having to click anything else. So let's just wait for that to finish and then we'll check that it's been installed successfully. All right, once Atom is installed, it will automatically load up. So we can see Atom has been installed correctly. Let's close off Atom and then move on to the final application and install ModHeaders. ModHeaders is a Chrome extension, so you want to make sure you have Google Chrome, a recent version of Google Chrome, installed on the system. Once you've got Chrome, head over to Google, and we're going to search for ModHeaders. You can see the top result here is the ModHeader extension in the Chrome Web Store. So click on that to load it. And once you're on the Chrome Web Store, all you need to do is click this Add to Chrome button. When it asks if you want to add ModHeader, click on Add Extension. And that's it. ModHeader is installed on the system. Okay, so that's all the applications that you need to install to follow on in this course. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.